Pisces, hello beautiful soul, how are you? My name is Alicia, welcome, welcome back. This is Empath Tarot, where spirit's messages correlate with being highly sensitive here on planet Earth. Now in this reading, we're going to pull some messages that are going to help uncover any love or abundance blocks you may be experiencing at this time, money or love. If there is a certain amount of money you would like to manifest into your life or a specific person, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe. If you are interested in receiving a personal reading with myself and Spirit, all of the details will be down in the description box below, along with my husband. If you haven't yet, check him out. He is over at 7D Tarot. And be sure to stick around until the end of this reading. We're going to be pulling a final message from your angels. Now, we want to remind you of one thing, and that's your energy and how open it has to be in order to receive. And we're not open and we're not in the receival mode if we are not willing to look internally at ourselves when we are reactive in our lives. And so we want to just remind you that your connection to your higher self is going to be the only thing we want you to prioritize right now. We have the Hierophant here and we have the Devil in reverse. So if you have limiting beliefs going on, it means there needs to be a greater connection. And I am so sorry, my autofocus is just crapping out on me. But it's very important that we are in the awareness that when we are feeling emotionally worn out and overwhelmed, we are taking time in the day to give ourselves that opportunity to heal and reflect and renew. And I am so sorry. I don't know what's going on here today. I have to get my husband to come and check it out. But either way, what we want you to remember is that, again, it's always about, are you open to new things? And if you're very limiting in your thoughts, you're going to create blocks. So what we want you to do is write down this affirmation in the comments below. I am open to receiving money. I am open to receiving money. I am open to receiving money. Proclaim it to the universe. We want to remind you that the only thing that will ever hold you back is the energetic frequency of fear. And the thing with fear is it is just an illusion. It feels real in the body because we have energy stored in the body that is from past traumas. So anytime we've had an emotional reaction and we have reacted, arguing, fighting, drinking, drugs, whatever it is, if we've reacted to that, then we are keeping those traumas stored in the body. They're called samskaras, and they're energy blockages that happen when we react to something. And then when we react, we keep them stored away. So anytime we've been in a relationship that didn't work out and we've reacted, it's been stored away. And then so when a familiar situation happens in our present time and space, we connect, we are going to feel very emotional. And then when that energy comes up, that's where we're going to want to be asked to heal. Anytime emotion comes up in the body, that's when we're at being asked to heal. So anytime emotion does come up, we don't want you to shove it back down, tell yourself how limiting you are and how you're not going to be worthy. All that stuff is an emotional, again, reaction. That's why we tell you first and foremost to have the physical body in your first awareness. It's the transforming the body, transforming the mind, and then you transform your life, because your physical body is your channel. It's your antenna. And if that is not, if that you don't exercise, if you don't eat healthy foods, you're going to have a lot of problems here. You're going to have a very hard time thriving here. As a matter of fact, there will be no thriving. It will be a life of suffering and a lot of anxiety and a lot of limits. And whether or not you are lean or not, or a thin, naturally thin person, we don't exercise for aesthetics. You want to look at exercise to raise your frequency. You'll notice such a difference in your life and what you're able to bring in. And we see here that you have beautiful results waiting for you, right? So you're always being guided towards the abundance that you deserve. It's just that a lot of times when we feel that we've made a mistake or that something hasn't gone the way that we wanted it to, is that it was our fault. It's connected to shame or guilt of some kind. I'm so sorry, Pisces. I do apologize. This is the vulture spirit here. Nothing is wasted. We want you to remember that nothing is wasted here on planet Earth. We're going to just go with it for today. I hope you can forgive me. My energy is dwindling. So what needs to happen is the awareness that when we are not connected and in tune with our true self, we're centered, we're feeling grounded, we're feeling balanced, then we're going to be very reactive in this game of life. When we're very reactive, we end up saying things and doing things that don't reflect our true state. When this happens, we end up attaching shame and guilt to that reaction as if we are not good enough, we are not worthy. And then we end up feeling that same shame and guilt in familiar situations. We want you to look at this game of life almost like an iceberg, right? So at the top of the iceberg is the conscious mind. And when we have this this situation that shows up on the tip of the iceberg and we see it, say, for instance, you want to lose that weight, or you want to, you know, start working out, or you want to, you know, start meditating more, right? Or what have you, right? You want to do these things, but you haven't yet. There's resistance in there somewhere, right? There's limiting beliefs, maybe what's it going to do for me? Every time the alarm goes off, you don't wake up, whatever it is. Chances are guaranteed that actually 100%, there's an energy cord that's beyond the surface attached to an emotion of shame or guilt somewhere in there. And so what we encourage you to do is, in a meditative state, right? In a state where you are at peace, focus on that thing you want to do, and then feel out that energy cord and what's attached to it. Is there shame? Is there guilt attached there? And maybe it's, you know, not doing something because a fear of needing approval, or a fear of poverty, or just fear of criticism, right? Anything that, whatever is attached to that, sit with that. Because that's how you heal. When you sit with that emotion, you're able to heal. And we want you to right now really connect to your passion, right? Doing what excites you. And sometimes we are guided into doing something, but we have this fear or this shame or this guilt attached to that certain thing that we are being connected to. And when that happens, it just generates these limiting beliefs, you see? So again, we feel like right now there is a new path, an opportunity that the universe is guiding you here with this Ace of Wands, right? A new adventure of some kind with this Ace of Wands. But we feel like you're having a hard time moving forward with it. And it's merely just because of a lack of balance in life. And that balance always comes from the balance of connecting to ourselves and connecting to the physical world. Beautiful soul, you are an infinite soul that does not, you're just a visitor here on planet Earth. You're just a visitor. And anytime we connect too strongly to our home, to our bodies, to where we're from, we really connect to that identity, right? I'm the daughter of this person, I'm the son, the husband, whatever it is, right? And the difficulty with that is it leaves us feeling really black and white. And you are a limitless, infinite being that is able to connect to so many multiple timelines. You're an interdimensional being. So you're able to connect to multiple outcomes. But if you're connecting too much to what is happening, I see this happening in my life, I know I'm from here, this is where I'm from, then you're connecting too much to the past and what is, and then you're not creating the life you want, you're just reacting to the life you want. And then what is happening is just going to keep circulating and circulating. In order for you to connect to a different timeline and a better opportunity for yourself, you have to sit with yourself in stillness. You have to actually spend time with yourself. And if you don't want to spend time with yourself because you don't like who you are, you don't like sitting with yourself because of how uncomfortable you feel, it all boils down to the physical body, right? The physical body is where we store our toxins and our emotions. And that is why we exercise, that is why we eat clean foods, and that is why we have the conscious intention to take care of ourselves. How are you going to heal others if you don't heal yourself first, beautiful soul? How are you supposed to attract in romance and connection and love if you don't love who you are? You're going to end up attracting in somebody who shares the same energy frequency. What good is that? Then you're going to have to go through the healing process. And at this stage of the game, we don't want to do that. Heal yourself and then attract in the being that's meant for you, right? But if you're suffering in your relationships, money in your bank account, it's because you're not connecting to yourself. There's too much focus on your outer world. What is happening? This is happening. That's happening. I don't have this. I need to do that. All that stuff, beautiful soul, is going to leave you feeling really ungrounded, because whatever we focus on, we mirror and we mimic. That's why if you focus on connecting to your higher self and really prioritizing that inner voice within yourself, you're going to start to mirror and mimic who you actually are. And when that happens, that is when you're going to be acquainted with your purpose. You're going to be acquainted with what comes next for you, you see. That's why it's the most important thing. And it goes body and then mind and then life. Now, your angel message today is entrepreneur. Let's see if we can get this. There we go. Entrepreneur. So your angel message, your angels are telling you, self-employment suits your disposition and intentions. Working for yourself allows you to better follow your intuition and divine guidance. We are your co-workers and teammates who remain loyally by your side to ensure your success in all ways. So you are destined for greatness. Entrepreneurship is in your destiny. You've got to connect to your own self. Body, mind, and then the life changes. Your physical world, what you see in front of you, is a complete reflection of what's going on internally. So if your relationships, again, are suffering or failing, if you're not attracting in the outcome you desire, things are on a pause, it's because internally you have to look inside of yourself and ask yourself, what am I not doing? And if you don't know, it's okay. Focus first on waking up early, exercising your body, grabbing a book, learning something new, taking some notes, journaling, talking to yourself, scripting, automatic writing. These activities connect us to who we are because it's an internal practice, you see. We're cleansing our energy, we're raising our frequency. So important that we focus on that. That's step number one. And then all things will unfold after that. We love you so much. We hope you enjoyed your reading. We hope there were messages in here for you. If there was, like and subscribe. We truly appreciate you. Spirit loves you. I love you. And until our next reading, keep shining, baby.